Independence Day in the US and Super Saturday in the UK resulted in revelers coming together to celebrate on both sides of the Atlantic on July 4th. However, the crowds are drawing criticism for their lack of social distancing amid the coronavirus pandemic. Beaches in San Diego, California, Cocoa Beach, Florida, Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and Coney Island, New York were busy over both July 3rd and 4th, photos suggest. Cocoa Beach in Florida was busy on July 4th, although there were fewer people than previous Independence Day weekends. Getty, Paul Hennessy, newer photo Saturday also saw Florida and Texas reporting record-high coronavirus cases, according to the FT. Miami-Dade County Mayor Carlos Jimenez had last week announced an emergency order to close all beaches in the county for the 4th of July weekend. The majority of beaches in Southern California were also closed, according to the LA Times. Americans flocked to Myrtle Beach in South Carolina on July 4th. Getty, Sean Rayford. Other parts of the U.S. still marked the occasion, such as Belfouche, South Dakota, where a parade was followed by a rodeo, evening dance, carnival and other festivities. The Independence Day Parade in Belfouche, South Dakota. Getty, Scott Olson. Many Independence Day parades, parties, and fireworks displays across the U.S. were canceled in light of the country's rising coronavirus numbers, but this didn't stop the White House from throwing a large event with a flyover and fireworks, Business Insider's Michelle Mark reported. While masks were offered to members of the public attending the event on the White House's South Lawn, they were not compulsory, and many people didn't wear them, according to the New York Times. Across the Atlantic, many Brits came together on July 4th to celebrate England's reopening of bars, pubs, and restaurants. Revelers in Soho, London, on July 4th. Getty, Peter Summers. In what is being called Super Saturday, eateries and bars were able to welcome back customers, provided they could maintain social distancing. However, photos suggest that as the night went on, many people gave up trying to maintain their distance. Police were on hand in Soho. In central London, the streets of Soho bustled with drinkers savoring their first pints of beer in months, with police monitoring the situation. Chairman of the Police Federation John Apter was on shift in Southampton, England. He said, "What was crystal clear is that drunk people can't, won't socially distance," the Evening Standard reported. "It was a busy night, but the shift managed to cope. I know other areas have had issues with officers being assaulted." A police officer surveys the crowds in London. Getty, Justin Tallis, AFP. On social media, people have been expressing their concerns over the images and fears of a second wave of the coronavirus. Estate agent Stephen Lowe tweeted a video of the scene in Soho at 10 p.m., describing it as absolute madness.